next guest is a very talented man you know from 5 seasons of Homeland. Now he reports to Lord Vader himself in Obi-Wan Kenobi. You can see it on Disney Plus. Please welcome Rupert Friend. Great to have you. You know, I was a big fan of your work on Homeland.
Yeah.
Where they, that was the first time I'd seen you, and they tried to kill you like 37 times on that film.
Yeah, they shot me, they drowned me, they gassed me, they woke me up from a coma. They was like, just cancel my contract and I'll go.
Were you misbehaving behind the scenes? What was going on
there? I was trying to behave, but I guess that Peter Quinn had 9 lives and they wanted to push that one to the end.
Yeah, maybe more than 9
maybe
even,
more,
I'm not sure.
37 apparently.
Now, you're on the show Obi-Wan Kenobi, which is obviously a very big deal. From a professional standpoint, is it like, for you personally, is being part of the Star Wars universe something like you'd always dreamed of?
Yeah, I mean, when the call came, I completely freaked out because it was, you know, this huge universe.
And what does that look like when you freak out?
It's like this a bit, a bit of blah in there, you know? And then I read this amazing script and there was this description of this very enigmatic guy who loved the sound of his own voice and delivered this long, rambling monologue before he got to the fun stuff, and you can empathize. It was wild, it was wild. And then finding yourself like on the planet Tatooine, striding down the main street to the cantina where...
Oh, you guys shot on Tatooine?
We went to Tatooine, yeah.
Wow. Tax breaks, right?
Yeah, they have a very good tax break there. The hotels are terrible, but... and, you know, you're seeing this cantina where I watched, you know, Han Solo and the music, and Deb Chow, our director, would play the music. So you start, you know, getting into that, which is not very character appropriate for this particular guy. But, no, it was a dream.
This particular guy is a former Jedi who's now a Jedi hunter.
Yep.
And he wants to kill the... Oh, there you go. The Grand Inquisitor.
Yeah, he hasn't seen the sun in a while.
Too. Yeah.
But, yeah, that's he. That's him.
Yeah, that's his skin. That's his skin. Well, you're obviously wearing makeup.
Yes.
Yeah, how much makeup do you have? Like, how long does it take to get that going?
That was 4 hours to get it on.
For real?
Yeah.
I could do that in 40 minutes, no problem. I could speed that up for you.
How would you do that?
How would I do it?
SPF 100? What is that?
I don't know. Well, what's the bulb on the head? That's not your head shape, is it?
Yeah, it's like a kind of boiled egg vibe. But basically, they had to put, you know, all these pieces of stuff on and contact lenses in and teeth in and then earmuffs. So it was kind of like sensory deprivation at times. And then by the end of a day's shooting, the whole thing, which was glued, watertight glued, was filled with sweat. Oh. And would slosh as I walked. So this is accompanying this kind of sloshing sound. And then to get out of it, they get a pair of scissors and cut you out. And this torrent of sweaty glue would just fall down my face.
And it's like having an aquarium on your head.
A little bit, a little bit, yeah.
So it's not all glamorous, is what you're saying.
No, it's definitely a mixed bag.
Yeah, okay. And that's every day you have to do that.
So I would arrive at 3 a.m. and I would have 6 pairs of hands all over me, which maybe sounds great to some people, I don't know. But, and we would be ready to work at 7, but we'd already been there in the middle of the night, so.
So in episode 2, you get a lightsaber. Mm-hmm. Oh, by the way, did you know you were gonna have a lightsaber? Was that part of the explanation, the pitch, when they
called
you? I don't
think it landed until they handed it to me, and it's this double-ended, heavy, spinning, badass thing. I mean, I don't know, have you ever held a lightsaber?
No.
Anything double-ended?
I've held some double-ended things, yeah, sure.
Yeah? Yeah. So you know.
Yeah. I mean, not a lightsaber, but...
Yeah.
Okay, so you get your lightsaber. Do you get to keep that, or do you have to leave that with
it? No, sadly, no.
And then you got stabbed, your character got stabbed.
Yeah.
Through the stomach.
One of them.
One of the stomachs.
Yes.
Okay. Because your character has 2 stomachs, like a hippo or something.
Half a cow, yeah.
Yeah. Mm. So that is what many of the Star Wars analysts / nerds are saying the reason you are able to survive this is because you have another stomach.
You know that I survived this?
Yes.
How?
I don't know, I'm just throwing it out there and seeing how you react.
It's a great try. It's a great try.
It's my double-ended thing of interviewing, yeah. No, but I assume you do, or else why would you be here right now?
Yeah, right.
I mean, you wouldn't be saying, watch the show. You'd be saying, screw them. They brought me out, they put my head in an egg, sweat went everywhere. It was an absolute nightmare. Now they want me to say, watch it?
They did a homeland on
me. Screw you, Disney. I'm not doing any of that
stuff.
Right,
yeah. No, I can see the logic. And I also think you're making a valiant effort to get me to do a spoiler, which obviously I'm not going to do.
Right. Well, yeah.
Unless you have another
Nobody wants that.
Try,
Nobody but... wants that.
Yeah.
So in the next episode, you are, you're...
Jimmy Kimmel, ladies and gentlemen.
How does the brand... That's good. Maybe I'm the Grand Inquisitor. You ever think about that?
That's true. We've never seen us in the same room before.
So. That is true, yeah. So, Star Wars, let's get back to the kind of, like, root of this thing, which is when you're a kid, really, right?
Yeah.
Did you go to the movie when you were a kid? Was it like, did you have the toys?
Okay, so, to fill you in, I grew up in a tiny village in England called, believe it or not, Stonesfield.
Really?
Yeah, really. That's a real place. You can look it up, and it sounds like a sort of hobbity place.
Yeah.
It sort of was. People had hairy feet, that kind of thing.
But how many people lived in that town?
Under 1,000.
Really?
It wasn't a town, it was a village. You know, stone walls. My house was 400 years old, I'm not joking. It was that world. And so we didn't get a VCR till I was 16 years old. Mm-hmm. There was no movie theater.
Same here, by the way.
Really?
16, yeah.
Yeah. That's weird. Okay.
Begged for it.
Yeah.
Begged for it.
Yeah. I didn't see Star Wars first. I got to hang out with a group of older guys who all used to play Star Wars.
Like, how old were these guys playing Star Wars? Sounds like your parents weren't very careful.
What? Yeah, it's true.
They didn't try to touch your lightsaber, did they?
That's true. It's true, now I think about it. It takes some re-examining, maybe. But, yeah, so they would all take character names and they'd run around in the woods and play, you know, dress up and all that. This doesn't sound good.
No. No, it doesn't sound good at all.
Yeah, I must revisit this and talk to my mother, apparently. But, you know, they would pick characters from the show. So there was an overweight guy and he was Jabba the Hutt. And then there was...
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Really?
Really?
One of them named himself Jabba, or did the other kids name him Jabba?
Well, I mean, it was like...
Because that doesn't sound like it. Like, I want to be Jabba.
Let me do it. Yeah. I think it was like the Goonies. He sort of owned it. You know, he kind of owned it.
All right, good.
And then there was a very hirsute man who was Chewbacca, you know. A very youthful, slightly awkward guy was Luke. And, you know, everyone had a character, and that's kind of how it went.
And then you went to the dark side.
And then I went to the dark side.
Would you, if you had to choose, would you rather be a hero or a villain in the Star Wars world?
I love being a villain in Star Wars.
You do, yeah.
I love it.
Yeah, it's fun. It's more fun to be the villain, right?
It's great. Yeah.
So in the next episode, the Grand Inquisitor eats a bunch of Tums and is okay?
What did the prostitute say to the leper?
Oh, I don't know.
I'm not going to answer that. Can I?
What's going on in that town?
I don't know. I'm just trying to change the subject off the spoilers.
Do you have lepers in the town?
It was a leper colony.
There's a leper colony. Oh, interesting. Yeah, wow.
Yeah. I escaped.
Well, we'll skip the handshake at the end then. And it's great to have you here. We'll see what happens. You know what? We'll find out. It's new episodes of Obi-Wan Kenobi Wednesdays on Disney Plus. Rupert Friend, everybody. Thank you, Rupert. We'll be back with music from Simba. Congratulations on making it to the end of a YouTube video. Why not celebrate by clicking the subscribe button? You earned it.